Holy shit. That's all I gotta open up this video talking about this recent news story. As a Calgary Flames fan, I'm shocked, stunned. The Calgary Flames made a coaching change. As I woke up this morning, I saw the Calgary Flames won 7-3 against the Ottawa Senators. But the two parts that makes it shocking is, one, they decided to fire head coach Jeff Ward and maybe some fans, media. There was some disconnect in the locker room with the inconsistent play, you know, or special teams either look good one game or bad the other game, where we win big or lose big. And there, it sounds like there's not everyone's not on the same page in the locker room. Like the team was trying to get the coach fired. Well, the Calgary Flames did indeed fire Jeff Ward. Jeff Ward, the rest of the coaching staff remains intact. Who do they replace Jeff Ward with? Daryl is coming back. As in Daryl Sutter. I had to do a double take when I saw after the Calgary Flames, they fired Jeff Ward and they brought back Daryl Sutter. Wow. I can't believe they did both. Because as much as the Calgary seem to be more of a coaching graveyard in the NHL, the National Hockey League, it's actually very rare that the Calgary Flames have make a coaching change during the season. And definitely, you're going to say there's some connection where Daryl Sutter comes in mid-season again, as this is the second tour of duty with the Calgary Flames as head coach. And hopefully, he'll only get to be head coach this time. Because I'm going to say he's a great coach, especially in the short term, to shake things up. Well, I'm going to say this is definitely more of an earthquake for a shakeup. That when the Calgary Flames first brought in Daryl Sutter in the 2002-03 season to replace, ultimately, Greg Gilbert and Al McNeil was in for a couple weeks, and I say he did pretty well given the circumstances. The Calgary Flames definitely improved their defensive play and played a lot more accountable and definitely provided some hope. And then in his first full season in Calgary, obviously, 2003-04 was that magical run to the Stanley Cup Final where we were well so close to winning. It still stings. And you know, then he had one more season in the 5-6 season. The lockout season happened. And then he decided to focus on the general manager duties. And I'm going to say Daryl Sutter didn't necessarily leave Calgary on the best of terms after when he decided to step down to be just general manager only as head coach. And then we went through Jim Playfair for a year. Mike Keenan for a couple seasons. Yes, Iron Mike was head coach of the Calgary Flames. And then we brought in Brent Sutter. And it seemed like there was a disconnect between Brent Sutter and Daryl Sutter, coach and general manager, and then eventually the brass asked him to leave. But that was over 10 years ago. But I'm just stunned that we brought him in. Daryl Sutter is coaching the Calgary Flames again. And I just have, you know, just a few mixed emotions. I mean, I like the potential on the shakeup that it looks like this team needs, where we have been playing inconsistent, where we either seem to lose big or win big. And it seemed like the team was playing to get Jeff Ward, the coach, fired. Well, he's fired. Now we're bringing in Daryl Sutter, who's proven to be, he has a winning track record. I mean, he has two, or I should say three, potentially should have three Stanley Cups as head coach, where he led the Los Angeles Kings to the Stanley Cup in 2012 and 2014. At least in the short term, this is definitely going to be a huge shakeup for the Calgary Flames, where I'm going to say either the core is going to change or the core is going to get changed. What I mean by that is either the core, you know, especially I'm going to say Johnny Gaudreau and Sean Monahan, they're either going to eventually maybe find their way out of Calgary, or they're going to change their attitude and game and behavior to work under Daryl Sutter. Some other players I think I would say might be more excited to have potentially Daryl Sutter come in. I think Milan Lucic, Matthew Tkachuk, I definitely think we're going to flourish under a lot more with Daryl Sutter and his playing coaching style. Maybe a lot more of our pluggers like a Zach Rinola, Brett Ritchie, or even some of our depth players that we haven't seen much of this season. But hopefully this change could maybe shake things up, you know, proving that we have a proven winning coach instead of just, you know, a young up-and-coming coach who has won elsewhere or has won as an assistant. That seems to have been the Calgary Flames thing for the last few seasons. But I'm still just stunned that we brought in Daryl after all these years. I mean, it's been over 10 years. I mean, and he proved that he is a great coach, but he was associate general manager based on his drafting and trading record here in Calgary. But with those two Stanley Cups in Los Angeles, maybe that'll get their attention right away. It's almost similar to, you know, a few other coaches that have had success. I mean, like John Tortorella. I know Mike Keenan also had a reputation of being a hard ass but have success. I mean, this is going to be interesting to see how it's going to go. I'm going to see it's either going to work very well or it might even be even worse. I just don't see it in between with this. And I mean, Daryl Sutter, he's 62 years old right now, and he did sign a 3-year deal with the Calgary Flames, so it's not like he's just here for the rest of the season to try to see how things go and then we'll evaluate it. He signed for the rest of this season, next season, 21-22, and then 22-23. So there could be a lot of change, possibly, either in personnel or players' attitudes, but I still have to say, holy shit with this, because I just can't believe it happened. Now we made the change and brought Daryl Sutter back. That required a double take. I was like, I'm reading this right. Daryl Sutter is back as head coach. I mean, he has been out of the game. If you look at his career coaching stats, I mean, he had success here in Calgary as head coach, obviously. You know, I think when we came in for the 2002-03 season, despite the Flames already being out of the playoff race and done that season, I think they did provide some hope, and then obviously the magical run in 2004. But overall, in his head coaching record, he has coached 1,285 games. He has won 635 games, lost 467 games, and then he has 101 ties and 82 overtime shootout losses. I mean, he's been in the playoffs 14 times, won 2 Stanley Cups. We can debate 3, because he had it in 2012, 2014. With the Los Angeles Kings, and came also close in 2004 with the Calgary Flames. And then, even with the Calgary Flames, he coached 210 games in his first stint. He had 107 wins, 73 losses, 15 ties, and 15 overtime shootout losses, and then got into the playoffs both his full seasons in 2004 all the way to the Stanley Cup Finals. And then we lost that series against the Anaheim Mighty Ducks in 2006. And that's when he decided to step down as coach and be general manager only. But it's funny how it seems like we are going back to a Sutter yet again. Kind of similar when we brought Daryl Sutter in the first time, that we had Brian Sutter for 3 seasons and then moved on from him. And we had Don Hay, who didn't last a year. And then Greg Gilbert was part of that coaching staff with Don Hay. He took over as head coach and had some initial success. And then team was in disarray, fell out, and then we had Al McNeil for a couple weeks as he was on the staff to take over on an interim basis, and then we brought in Daryl Sutter after he was recently let go from San Jose because he had some success in San Jose. And after that, I mean, the carousel seemed to kept continuing. We had Jim Playfair, then we had Mike Keenan, and I think this is just as shocking to the time when we hired Mike Keenan, where I first found out how Mike Keenan was the head coach of the Calgary Flames. I was getting off the bus, going to the train station. Walked by the newspaper, and then the Sun at the time, you know, covered up the headline with a sticky for an ad. And I saw a picture of Mike Keenan's face on the front page of the Sun, and I was wondering, why the hell is Mike Keenan's face doing on the front page of the Sun? And I was like, don't tell me he's coaching here now. And then he was here for 2 seasons, kind of similar to Daryl. Almost coming back. At least got in the playoffs, but never got out of the hump. And then we had Brent Sutter, and that's where I think the downfall of Daryl Sutter's tenure as general manager came into being. And I didn't think he'd left Calgary on the best of terms. And then he eventually, after a year and a half of being asked to step down as general manager, and eventually he took over as the Los Angeles Kings in the 11-12 season, and the team was kind of in disarray at the time and made the playoffs and won 2 Stanley Cups in 3 years in 2012-2014. However, eventually, I think he had a shelf life where eventually, towards the end of his tenure with the Los Angeles Kings, he was locked out of the dressing room. And eventually, when he got into the dressing room, he had to go through a bunch of trash cans. And then he served as an advisor with the Anaheim Ducks the last few years. But, I mean, I'm just stunned. We brought Daryl Sutter back as head coach. I would never, ever, ever thought that. And I mean, there's a pretty much a whole new regime now. I mean, the only players that will be familiar with Daryl Sutter was Mark Giordano. Actually, he was signed by Daryl Sutter as general manager in the summer of 2004. Played under him in his rookie season, you know, 5-06. And then Michael Backlund, who was drafted by Daryl Sutter in 2007. Never played under him, but he was general manager. But basically, you have a whole new regime. And I'm just going to say, maybe some of the reputation that he has a winning record, has a couple Stanley Cups, and the fact that he's proven that he can be a hard ass but has some success right away, could this be what the team needs right now? I mean, I just can't believe it happened. I mean, like I say, going back to the Carousel after Brent Sutter, we had Bob Hartley, who was the first and only coach to win the Jack Adams for Coach of the Year. I mean, he was proven to be, you know, a tougher coach as well, and some of the core players eventually got tired of him, especially when we were winning. So then we had Glenn Gallant for a couple of years, and then we had Bill Peters, who we had initial success, but then, you know, unplanned circumstances what warranted his exit from the Calgary Flames. And then Jeff Ward, I still say at that time, I still stand by it that I think he deserved a shot to be the head coach because he saved the season last season. But wow, I just can't believe after only 24 games in this season, I mean, keep in mind we're almost halfway through the season, we might still have some hope if we can track down Montreal or even Edmonton to get into the top four in the North All-Canadian Division. Montreal is definitely going to be another team that's going to be on a change because they recently moved on from Claude Julien. But I mean, I'm expecting, obviously, this team to play tougher, to play against, hopefully be a lot more accountable. And Daryl Sutter's proven to have better, you know, special teams and less turnovers than that. However, I'm just going to wonder how it's going to go with some of the core players. I think some of the core players are going to embrace being under Daryl Sutter, and maybe Sam Bennett, maybe he'll get more of an opportunity, and maybe he'll say, you know, that trade request, maybe I'll take it back. But it'd be interesting to see how Sean Monahan and Johnny Gaudreau will play under him. But I think Milan Lucic and Matthew Tkachuk, I think they'll probably enjoy playing under him a lot more. Maybe Matthew Tkachuk will get to be more of that pest, because I think he was suppressed a little more at points of the season. Just as long as it doesn't get Brad Marchand to toxic levels. But, wow. Daryl Sutter is back. He's back. I'm just trying to come to grips with that. And there's word that he won't be back right away, or he won't be back with the team in person for the first few days, I think because of travel and COVID core protocol. But things are definitely going to change, and maybe hopefully for the better, but we'll see. But what do you think about this? I mean, I'm stunned that they've moved on from Jeff Ward, and they brought in Daryl Sutter. Who would have thought that he'd be back coaching in the NHL and with the Calgary Flames after, you know, so many years? I mean, I'm bringing back some nostalgia because I felt that he stepped down too soon just to only focus on, you know, the general manager part. I mean, I get his plate was full, but he definitely has proven he's a great coach, but a social general manager. I'm just going to say, as long as he's just coach, we'll see how this plays out. I guess I can say, welcome back to the Sea of Red, Daryl Sutter. I never, ever thought I would see you back here in Calgary as coach or anywhere in the organization, but hopefully maybe this will be what this team needs right now. But you get why I'm shocked as a hockey fan and watching this, but I could see it either work very well or be a disaster where eventually, you know, the team's going to really overhaul and change things, and hopefully, you know, this will just change the stagnation. But Daryl Sutter is back as Calgary. Wow. That's all I can say. So anyway, as I say, if you want to follow along with this Calgary sports fan's journey, home of the Flames, Hibbing, and Roughnecks, and Stampeders, I mostly do talk Calgary sports on my YouTube channel. It's definitely been a lot more interesting with the Calgary Flames, and this season's definitely got a lot more interesting now on the ice, but off the ice. But we'll see how things will go with Daryl Sutter. Yes, Daryl Sutter now back as coach of the Calgary Flames. Maybe I'll look back on some of those sound bites again in higher definition now. But I also do variety of non-sports content, like personal vlogs, Santa Gandhi, and I also do share my experience say I'm on the road or a sporting event. So if hell sounds like be interesting to watch, do follow along with this Calgary sports fan's journey. You know what you do, just to make sure you like, subscribe. I also have my other social media links down in the description below. Excuse me. And wow, this Calgary sports fan's journey just got a lot more interesting. Daryl Sutter is back as Calgary Flames head coach. I almost would have thought that would have happened after when we moved on from Mike Keenan before Brent Sutter got hired, but these circumstances are weird. Well, we'll see how it goes, but anyway, I just wanted to say thanks for watching. Welcome back to the Sea of Red. Daryl Sutter, is it time to bring back those Insider Retrust signs? Or are we anxious to show him the door again back when he was general manager? It just never seems to be dull with the Calgary Flames, and I'm stunned. That's all I can say. Holy shit, Daryl Sutter is back with the Calgary Flames as head coach. So let's say go Flames go, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Wow.